Ladies and gentlemen, only one spot remains in the tournament semifinals. So the last of our quarterfinal matchups features Sofyan Lajduni and Rico Verhoeven.
Donc ouais, je suis passionné de la boxe parce que depuis tout petit, je suis dedans, j'ai une famille de boxeurs. Et certes, pour le tournoi, je regardais ça étant petit. Quand j'étais petit, je regardais le tournoi à la télé. Donc là, d'y être et d'y participer, c'est une très bonne opportunité pour moi. En plus, j'ai battu Benjamin Adekbi pour y accéder. Donc c'était un gros boxeur, un gros défi. Et je suis là et je montre à tout le monde que j'ai ma place dans le tournoi.
Sofyan Lajduni!
Look at the Frenchman fire away! This is heavyweight glory action at its best!
Badr Hari, c'est quelqu'un que j'ai toujours regardé ses combats. J'aime bien sa boxe. J'aime la personnalité de Badr. C'est un guerrier. Il va à la guerre, il ramène du monde, tout le monde est derrière lui. C'est vraiment, c'est mon boxeur préféré. Donc si je remporte le trophée, j'ai une place déjà bien définie dans ma collection de ceintures pour lui. Et ça lui ira très bien. Donc si je gagne 500 000 $, déjà je penserai à investir, c'est important. Après maintenant j'ai un petit garçon d'un an et trois mois, donc je penserai plus à mon fils que je penserai à moi.
After so many years, Glory coming back with the Grand Prix, I love it. I love it. And how cool would it be if you, yeah, take that home as well? And literally, like, put the cherry on top of the cake and say, hey, we literally done it all. That would be awesome.
That is it! The reign continues! Rico Verhoeven!
This is a big tournament. It's gonna take place in the Gelderdome. Feels like my second home. They have to be in early because we're gonna start off clubbing and banging from the very first moment we go live. So that's gonna be exciting, but that brings a lot of pressure as well. Back in the day, of course, we had the K1 tournaments. Yeah, I loved it. It was so much fun always to watch it, and I think that's where the dream started to become kickboxing world champion. And I think my favorite one still is Peter Ots beating everybody up within 10 minutes. So he won the whole tournament within 10 minutes, so that was crazy. So that's something we're going for. Now that would definitely be an amazing thing to, I don't know, for some kind of reason or whatever, it's written out that our roads come together again.
Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner, he is a French national and European champion. As a professional, 35 wins, 2 losses, 1 bout scored even, and 17 career knockouts. He stands 6'3" tall, 1.92 meters, and he weighed in at fight time at an even 230 pounds, 104.5 kilos. He's here tonight in the Netherlands, fighting out of France. Here is Sofyan Lajduni. Here now is his opponent, fighting out of the white corner, set to make his 25th glory appearance. His professional record, 61 wins versus just 10 losses, 20 of those wins coming by way of knockout. He stands 6'5" tall, 1.96 meters, and he weighed in at fight time at 271 pounds, 122.8 kilos. Fighting tonight out of the Netherlands, he is the king of kickboxing and the reigning heavyweight champion of the world. He is Rico Verhoeven. And the referee in charge of this bout, Yusuf Akhnik.
The fighters, you know the rules. I want to clear in a fair fight. Obey my commands at all time or take yourself without time, okay? Touch gloves. Take a step back.
Lajduni has promised not to be intimidated and go right after Rico. Is that the strategy you would employ?
100%. It's determined. The goal is to finish the opponent quick as possible. And with Lajduni, awkward style, switching stance and southpaw, normal punches, anything can happen.
Rico in the black trunks, Lajduni in the white. Lajduni qualified for this tournament. almost a year ago by beating Benjamin Adegbuyi. He said he's been basically training nonstop in preparation for this moment.
The man really switching stances more than we've seen him in the past. He's here in Orthodox.
Time stop.
And that's not what Rico needed to start this fight. The first strike right below the belt.
No, not at all.
And also the main thing in this fight will be Rico leg kicks. Yeah. How well Lodini will block those leg kicks, because we've seen it time and time again that they do big problems for all the fighters.
Yeah. Watch it, yeah. Okay, time. Fight!
We've seen Rico's boxing improve throughout the years. His low kicks always devastating.
Already switching stances is Laudini. Rico with the head kick. Rico looks so much bigger in there.
And I think the stance switching for Laudini could be to take away Rico's low kicks.
You can see how evasive Sofyan is, how well he's moved, how quick on the feet he is.
He is a smaller heavyweight, so speed and counters against Rico needs to come into effect.
Once Rico gets comfortable, Antonio, that's when he becomes most dangerous. We saw Jamal Ben-Sadiq take advantage in the early going.
Yeah, but also one thing with Rico, I can talk whatever I want, but he never earned respect for that. He never gives up. And also that's the thing that he showed against Jamal. You can never count him out.
Rico definitely knows how to win.
He's gotten off the canvas against Jamal Ben-Sadiq and Badr Hari. You can't question his heart, you can't question his skills or his resume. One of the, if not the greatest of all time.
I can maybe see Sofyan having some success when Rico comes starting in, hitting wind with a hook.
Break, step back, no action, step through.
Last year, Rico had reconstructive knee surgery, came back with a dominating win over Cookie Asaro.
It was his dominant performance there that really got him to enter this tournament.
Yeah, it was basically an easy night for him, but a lot of that fell on Cookie not really doing much.
And that's the thing with what I spoke before with Cookie. He's mostly counter-puncher. We can see here good work for Laudini. He's not intimidated by Rico, moves well, kicks.
Look at the size of Rico's legs.
Yes, every time I see that, I remain in shock.
It's like two tree trunks as he walks on Laudini.
It's like the legs from the man much bigger than him.
Ooh, good knee on the inside and into the body for Rico.
Yeah, Rico's comfortable now. You see him using his feints, putting his strikes together, chopping the legs.
A good round for Rico, I think.
Rico Verhoeven is keys. He's got to be a calculated pressure like you see him, using his feints, controlling the ring. He's got to throw those mixed combinations, boxing with low kicks, boxing with knees, and he's got to stay tight and use his low kicks. Laudini can counter from odd angles. The Frenchman, he's got to use maybe a little bit more of those southpaw tactics. He's switching a bit, but he's more of a natural southpaw with his boxing. And he's got to keep moving. Don't stay against the ropes where Rico can kind of pick you apart and stop you from moving.
Hey, one of Rico's biggest fans, Jason Statham, is here, the action star.
Yeah.
Great movies. I'm a big fan of his. I don't even know where he is. I might have to sneak a picture.
No, he comes to you for a picture. You understand that? That's You're it. The Glory Hall of Famer.
He's in my house.
There you go.
I like it.
All right, Laudini has to do something different here in round two as Rico seemed to pretty much control the first.
Moving back to his fainting style.
I want to see Laudini working a bit more with combinations and everything.
Yeah.
Like this. Throw everything, connect more punching combination. One of them may find success.
Eventually, Laudini's gonna have to open up if he's gonna wanna win, right? They're surviving and winning are two different things.
And we can see the scoring cards. First easy round win for Rico. He is controlling everything, the pace, the punches, the ring.
Yeah, Laudini has to get busy.
Break. Stop throwing.
I want to see him throw more combinations.
Maybe especially when Rico kicks, maybe whip a counter punches or
fight.
He's got to find a way to throw a little bit more, be more active.
There's a nice left from Laudini and a low kick from Rico.
Also from that southpaw stance, the backhand, the left hand. I can see him get some success with that.
Yeah, especially stepping outside of Rico's lead foot.
Break!
Try to split Rico's guard. Again, there's a king for the, he's the king for the reason.
Nice feints as always by Rico.
Break, no action, step back.
It seems like the same rhythm in this fight. Laudini's got to do something different. He keeps getting backed up in the corner against the ropes. Rico smothers him and they get broken up.
Yeah, I like Laudini taking this more active approach, throwing his combinations, not just waiting.
Step back.
Right now for Rico, this looks like a sparring, not the fight. It looks like he's just doing what his game plan is.
Break.
Don't risk nothing, pressure him, do more, win on points, next fight.
You know when Rico's comfortable, he likes to play with a southpaw, something he's been working on throughout the years.
Rico strikes well there, as you can see. Punches, kicks, and knees.
Break.
I say Rico won his first tournament at Glory 11. It's crazy he's still doing it.
It feels like that was a century ago.
Yeah. Insane to see him do it for so long and stay at the top.
To me, it looks like Rico is just right now on playing time. He's just trying everything, throwing high kicks, low kicks, moving punches. And Sofyan right now don't have any answer.
Whoa, a nice little moment there for Laudini.
Low kick.
Nice Quick. Superman punch also.
Stop!
Satisfied in the Rico corners by the looks of them. Happy with what he's doing, just finish it till the end.
Take no damage is the key.
Well, Rico's dominated the first two rounds. Do you expect anything to change in the third?
I see they're trying to wake Sofyan a bit to start working. Make pressure, throw punches and everything, but we will see if he's having something in reserve for the whole fight. Will he start?
For me, it's Laudini doesn't have the big power shot to slow Rico down.
Yeah.
If he had a big shot that scared Rico, it may slow the pressure down a little bit and help him out, but yeah. Not enough power to slow the king down.
You saw Laudini land a pretty solid punch there against the ropes, and it didn't faze Rico in the slightest.
It's like nothing is gambling. Rico is now literally manhandling him.
He's had his foot on the gas, throwing twice as many strikes and landing almost three times as many. Oh, good right from Rico. The legs. A little wobbly now for Laudini.
Shelled up. He's got to get out of this corner, out of his shell. Clinch up, if anything.
Good left from Rico.
You know how good Laudini is to get here. He has wins over Kahab, Adekbui. He's really earned his shot to be here with Rico.
Break.
Still no answers from
fight.
From Laudini. He needs to change something, start working. Cannot be backing up all the time because Rico is just doing whatever he wants.
Yeah, and Rico just still bouncing on his feet, not tired in the least. Like you said, almost like a sparring session or an exhibition.
Yeah, like literally like an easy sparring session for him.
Oh, good right hand. Similar to the one that knocked out Benjamin Adekunle several years ago.
Rico, when he connects with that back right hand, it's scary. Big power in that big frame.
Break, no action, sit back.
It looks like still nobody has any answer for the mystery of Rico Verhoeven.
Break.
Well, Antonio, you said you thought Lavdini would either pull off a shocking upset or get completely dominated, and I think it was the latter more than the former.
I hope that Lavdini will have some chance of Rico coming in, catching him in the hook when he opens up, but it looks like nothing happens.
Yep, Lavdini still waiting too long.
Just a dominating win from Rico. He's just playing right now.
He's not even worried about his hand position anymore, keeping his hands low.
No, this is just now play time for him.
Break. Need the elbow.
Take the fight to the finish and do the next one.
Rico, of course, used to fighting five rounders as the champ. So three should be no problem as he lands a good head kick.
Stop.
And that'll do it. A one-sided beatdown.
Yeah, we cannot say nothing. He just did what he needed to do to win.
Todd Grisham, Antonio Plazabat, the number one ranked heavyweight in the world today, and Joseph Valtellini, really no contest for Rico.
Yeah, it was easy work for Rico. It's honestly the perfect fight for him. He called Lavdini out and just played around, picked his shots, and he looks fresh for the semifinals.
Let's look at our replays from that, our final quarterfinal, as Sophie and Lavdini had great expectations, but in the end, he had little hope as it was a one-sided performance for Rico Verhoeven.
We can see total dominance from Rico, just doing whatever he wants. It looked like an easy sparring match or a play time. And when he needed, he pushed a little bit more gas and just finished the fight easy. Third round, same as the first and second round, just going straight through him. Good right punch there and just finishing the fight easy and going to the next one.
Final strike count statistics. Oh, look at this. 52 of 170 for Rico, 15 of 64 for Lavdini. He just could not get anything going. Strikes by zone, single digits, head, body, and legs for the Frenchman.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout goes the distance, so we go to the judges' scorecard. All five of our ringside judges see the bout and score the bout the same, 30-27, a unanimous decision, all for your winner, who now punches his ticket into the tournament semifinal, Rico Verhoeven.
I'm here with your winner, Rico Verhoeven. Nice, calm, and focused. Fight one done. Give me your thoughts so far.
Yeah, it was okay, but like I said, I hope everybody saw, he's a good kickboxer. And he defeated my next opponent, so he showed me how to do it.
Yeah, you're an experienced guy, especially in tournament. What happens now when you go backstage?
We try to stay warm, keep moving, look at where the damage is at my other opponent, and then move on from there.
All right, Rico, we're excited to see you in the semifinals. We'll see you soon. Let's hear it for your winner, Rico Verhoeven.